Hello, I'm Meli for Edu for Java, and this is tutorial number 2 on Android game programming. In this tutorial, we're going to learn to draw an image in surface view. This is a view of low level, which give us a lot of flexibility and is very efficient, which is important for games so that everything happens quickly. I'm going to make this tutorial following a tutorial which I have in my website, eduforjava.com, so that if anyone gets lost in the way here, you have the guide. Let's create a new Android project. Call Kill Them All Training. Kill Them All is the name I gave to the small application we are developing. This small game. Okay, here I choose the name of the project. Here you can choose whatever you want. We are going to choose the E8. For the application name, we're going to name it Kill Them All. For the package, we're going to put this. Here we're going to write main, and here 7 for compatibility. 7 is for 2.1. With this, we can select finish. And the project is generated. If you've seen my tutorials in Android, you know that a main is generated. And also a layout is generated too. We are not going to use this layout because we want a total control of the application. We're going to interact directly on the view. This view, instead of coming out of a layout, is going to be created by us. We create a new game view. I think it was called yes. We create the class create game view and finish. We have to include the constructors. We can choose. Okay, we select this one. We are obliged to choose one. Because of this, we have to put this here. The view needs a reference to the activity. Here we have the reference to the activity. That would be the context. Let's help us with a page. In the main, we don't have to do anything else. In the view, we have the context. Let's create a BMP, a bitmap. Let's put this here. Create a bitmap. We haven't got the bitmap declared, so let's first import the other one. Shift Ctrl O to import. And this one. Let's create a field. There it is. Ctrl S to save. And let's go back to the page because I have already forgot what we're doing. Here we create the bitmap. Afterwards, we have to override a method called undo. This method is going to be called. Okay, Shift Ctrl O for the import. This method is going to be called automatically from the view. In fact, I don't know if it's a view or a holder. A view is inside a holder, it's like a container. This holder manages the view. It tells the view what to do. The holder, in the same way, runs a code in the view. Inside the one we extend, and this code must run this undo. And here is where we can write in the application. This canvas object here is like the blackboard where we could write when we were little. Imagine we were at school and we had a blackboard. and we could write with a chalk. We write through a lot of methods of this canvas. Here we can see it has a lot. The first thing I do is tell him to make the background black, and afterwards I tell him to print the bitmap. This one I had already created in the position 10, 10. We will talk about this parameter null later on. When I get the bitmap, I use this static method from the bitmap factory. And I pass him the resources, which is mainly a view method. And this, if you remember from other tutorials, is an icon which comes with the application. This icon here, this one, we are going to use this one to not complicate things. Later on, we will use others. Let's go here. Okay, run us under the application. You're going to have to wait, but I had it already loaded. So here it is. As you can see, it opened and it printed. This is the bar I didn't want. We can take it out with the line, this one. In the activity, if we add this here, Ctrl Shift O to import, Ctrl S to save, and now we run again. Here it goes again. Can you see it disappeared? Okay, until now we have been printing with a view. Let's try it with a surface view. What we have to do is to replace this view with a surface view. If we run this, we're going to see something wrong. That the image doesn't print, because surface view is a lower level class, so all that code we were talking about, which makes the call to the ondo, if you remember, we haven't got it now, so we are going to have to call the method ourselves. Okay, to call the method, we need to know when to call it, and also we use the canvas object to call it. To do this, we should first get the holder, and afterwards do a holder callback. Here we're going to put the holder. This is a holder method in surface view, which give us the holder. Let's create a field, because we're going to use it in the future. And here we're going to include a call. We're going to register a class, which is going to be a listener of the events of the callback of the holder. Let's ask for help. It gives us the possibility to create an anonymous class which implements the interface surface holder dot callback. Here there is an error because we have to import the interface, this one. Here it is. This is an inner class. This is the same as creating a new class. The only difference is that everything is here all together. So that the object is a listener of the surface holder. We need that the anonymous class implements the methods of the interface callback. These methods are destroyed, which is going to tell us when the view is destroyed, when everything is finished. When it is created, and when it has a change. What we are interested in now is this one. This method is going to be run when the list is prepared to make prints. In this method, we're going to put this code. Which what it does is ask the holder, which comes as a parameter. We also have it as a property, but in this case it comes as a parameter. It asks the holder through the method log canvas. This null is not necessary. It asks for the canvas. Why log canvas? This method makes a lock to the canvas. It reserves it so that nobody else uses it. When we have C, we can call the onDraw method with the canvas. After calling the onDraw, we have to tell the holder to unlock it. This is important because the locks work against the performance of the application. It is very important in games because we are talking of real time. Let's run this. Okay, here it comes. Now it does print. We have to do it by hand. Okay, this is everything for this tutorial. I'll wait for you in the next one.